Binod, Binod, Binod. I'm pretty sure that you have heard this particular term in last 7 days. Let me be very specific. I guess last 3 days max to max, or you may be frustrated. What is wrong with the internet and why everyone is talking? And then you may have some ideas like, okay, should I create a content around Binod? Binod, being very specific in the accent. But before starting or telling you anything, you have to download 2 tools that I'm gonna tell you right now. These 2 tools are actually Chrome extensions. One of them is called VidIQ. Add it to your Google. Club it with another tool called as TubeBuddy. Yes, the first one. Now, once you add these 2 Chrome extensions, just go to YouTube, type that keyword which you think is a trend or something like that. Click on enter. This tool on the right hand side will tell you what's the trend. Now you can see there is a very strong spike which tells you that the trend is still existing and it will exist for a longer time. It has not been dead yet. That's the first reference or the inference you are getting. The second inference you can get, if you scroll down, it will tell you the overall score of this particular keyword called as Binod, the specific keyword. It tells you about the volume, it tells you about the competition. If the competition is very high, to rank for that particular keyword, it will be very difficult. If the competition is very low and the volume is very high, then that means it's a green signal, you can go ahead. That's the basic logic. Who are the top channels that are ranking for this search term? You can see the 3 top channels. And they also tell you the top related opportunities in terms of, I repeat, in terms of search term. So what is Binod? Who is Binod? If you want, you can create the content around it. And if you see on the left hand side, you can also see the number of content that has been uploaded in last 2 days. There are a lot of content, which means the competition is very high, but also it means that the trend is still going on. So maybe you should consider. Now, how to cross-check if we should consider the trend or not, and when to upload this? Click on Google Trends. It's absolutely free. Do the exact keyword search. Do not change anything in this keyword. Change your location to wherever you want according to your need. This trend is in India, so that's why I'm doing India. Change web search to YouTube search, because you don't want to understand web because you're uploading a YouTube video and not writing a blog. Change maybe to, let's say, past 7 days, because the trend did not exist before that. Now here, start looking for patterns. If I start seeing about the time, I see August 6, 8:30 p.m. spike, August 7, 9:30 p.m. spike, August 8, 8:30 p.m. spike again, and August 9, 8:30 p.m. spike. So what does it tell you? Actually, it's quite interesting. It tells you that every day after 8 p.m. or after 8:30 p.m., the search term is spiking, which means people are actively searching for this search term after 8 p.m. What does it tell you? That your video upload should be around 7:30 to 8 p.m. because YouTube works on recency. Recency is the biggest factor inside the whole algorithm of YouTube. There are many factors, but the highest rated factor is recency. Now you have decided what keyword you should choose and when you should be uploading the video. Now let's talk also about the tags. Now the good thing about this tool is this tool also tells you which are the tags your friend or the other creators have uploaded, and you can see the tag rankings. Now on the right hand side, if you see, this video is ranking for Binod search term in 1, and then who is Binod, then Binod meme, then Slay Point. Now what you just need to do is you just need to hijack these tags if they're absolutely related to your video. I repeat, if they're absolutely related to your video, because you do not want to confuse YouTube by creating another video and just using this tab because you think that, okay, it will get you enough views or not. No, it doesn't happen that way. If only you are creating a video around Binod or something very contextual, use these tags which other creators are already ranking for. What will eventually happen is you may get lucky to come inside the suggested section of these creators. Yeah, that's right. You may get additional suggested traffic by doing this. So yes, I hope you had fun and understanding to how to use these 3 tools combined to understand a trend and to craft your content strategy accordingly. Guess what? I actually upload these videos certain marketing learnings every week. If you want to get them to your home page, please subscribe to the channel so that you teach YouTube that, hey, I actually want these videos because they're relevant enough for me.